Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabid here. So I just put together another CPU mining rig. This is a 7950X3D, but the BIOS needs to be updated because it will not work. All right, so here is the BIOS information for the DS3H from Gigabyte. It is detecting the CPU, a 7950X3D, but you can see the BIOS version is F3, and support didn't come out to like F5, and I think the latest version is like F21 or something. So I'm gonna show you how to flash this BIOS fast and easy with Qflash. Looking at the SMU commands, it doesn't even have an eco mode here to enable. So I did have to go through these exact same steps with my previous build because I ordered these two motherboards from the same store and they both came with the early BIOSes. So the first thing you are gonna need here is a flash drive, this guy right here, and make sure you format it to FAT32. All right, so next thing you're gonna do is head on over to Gigabyte's website, look up your motherboard version, and then search the BIOSes. Here we can see F20, F21, F22. It looks like the latest version now is actually F22. Now, if there's an A or a B or a C or any other letter after the number, then it's a beta version. And I highly recommend not to use beta versions unless you have to. So I always recommend the latest stable versions, and you don't really need to update unless you're really having issues because you do have potential to brick your motherboard and that could be a bad day. So go in there and download the latest stable version for your motherboard. So once you do have that downloaded, you're gonna extract it and you will get your files like so. So this is the file you're gonna need right here, the B650M DS3H.F21. Remember, depending on the brand of your motherboard and depending on the version of the motherboard, it's gonna have different numbers here, but this is for my specific motherboard here. You're gonna copy this and paste it into your flash drive, and then you have to rename it. So I'm gonna bring up my flash drive here, I already renamed it. This is the exact same file, but you're gonna have to update it to gigabyte.bin. That is right, gigabyte.bin here. I'll zoom in so you can see it a little bit better. That is exactly how the file name has to be. At that point, you're going to eject your USB flash drive. Now you can also do this without any CPU or anything installed. I was gonna do it, but I wanted to show you exactly what my BIOS version was first and everything before I actually did it. But here, now you're gonna see the side of your motherboard. There is a red USB port with a little button beside it. So we're gonna plug this guy into that little red slot there. Next up, we are gonna need power. So if you're doing this with no CPU or anything installed, all you'd have to plug in is your 24 pin for the motherboard. You don't need any CPU power for this. So we're just gonna plug this in. There we go, this is turned on right now. So now we're gonna come to the front here and there's this little Qflash button. We're gonna hold this one down for like 5 seconds until everything starts flashing. So it's down, 1, 2, 3. So we can see flashing there. So it's only a couple seconds. It's reading the drive. We can see there everything's turning on and doing its thing. So right now it is flashing the hard drive. You don't touch anything until it's done flashing. Okay, so there's no more blinking going on here. So it is done and it should reboot all by itself. But I'm gonna shut it off now and we're gonna boot into the BIOS and see what things look like. So I shut it off and then I powered it back up here. I pulled the USB drive out. Now I'm gonna come to my power switch here, hit the button. I'm starting to hear some clicks, so it should boot up on its own here. Any minute we'll see some lights here. There we go, we can see the RAM kicking on here, fan is spinning. So let's jump into the BIOS, see what things look like. Okay, so we can see things are a little bit different now, and we can see we are now in BIOS version F21. And we can see in our SMU options here that eco mode has appeared. So thank you for checking this out, guys. This is how you do update the BIOS in your Gigabyte motherboards.